So I know what you're thinking, does the world need another LED downlight? Well, stay with us because we think we've found some great features in these additions to the F-Type range from Luceco.
There's some great features in here that save electricians time.
Well, Gary, we'll dive right in. It's a bit that electricians really care about. How easy are they to connect?
Yeah, and you wouldn't think when you look at connections, you could make them any easier than just pushing the cables in and pressing to release. But actually, the order makes them easier, believe it or not. Let's have a look.
Yeah, so yes, you're right. So the first thing that struck us is, some manufacturers have what's referred to as NEL,
yeah,
isn't it? So yeah, you've got to cross those wires over, especially when it comes to a twin and earth. But yeah, this one is NEL NEL.
And we like that. So again, when I'm pushing those in, yeah, it's great. You ain't got that one that kicks round and one kicks round from the other one. So that's a simple adjustment.
Okay, so we'll let you loose on one in the ceiling, didn't we? Let's have a look at how you got on with that, Gary.
So we have got cables hanging through the ceiling. I'm just going to strip them back using my Ideal Industries twin and earth strippers. So outer PVC followed by the inner PVC. And I'm just going to add my CPC sleeve in before I connect them into my F-type downlight. Lovely, look, we've got the order correct now that makes it simple to insert the conductors, no crossing over. So just push them into position and replace the screw. And then once I've done that, I'll be ready to pop it into the ceiling itself. So the springs are nice and powerful, just get those up. A bit worried about the fingers, but do I need to be worried about my fingers? We'll come to that in a minute. So pop it into position like so. Is it finished? Well, not quite. Watch this bit. Yeah, very nice.
Well, that was good, Gary. And obviously, yeah, a lot of people now are moving to sort of those screwless sort of clamps that go over the cables. And I found one problem that I think actually Luceco have solved.
Right.
Obviously, with the addition of a screw. So there is still that one screw in there.
Right, okay, let's have a look.
And yeah, screwless ones are fine when it comes to flat cables, but I've found on other ones we've looked at, they don't tend to grip around cables, which you might have if you're in, say, a more commercial environment.
And that screw there obviously helps hold that clamp in position. You think it's perfect for those round flexes?
Yeah, so that's one thing I would say. That's where the screw does come in.
Yeah, I agree with you on that. So again, another little detail that just makes it that little bit easier for us. Now there's a little bit of pain involved occasionally when fitting the odd LED downlights, and they've solved that problem to a certain degree as well, haven't they?
They have. Well, shall we have a closer look at that, Gary?
Yeah, we will. I like this.
Yeah, so we've got these little rubber rubber shrouds that go on the end of the springs.
Right.
Now, that's obviously there to help protect the actual damage. Sometimes these springs can be a bit aggressive, can't they? And suddenly they sort of twang and take some of the coating off the bezel.
Yeah.
But actually the good side effect of this is, yeah, even if I'm going to do something brave here,
come on.
The old sledge and injury there, you can see on the back of the thumbnail. Yeah.
Yeah, that's just saved a little bit there for you. Small. But effective again. I did like that little soft touch. And we took a set off here because we had a little play with those, didn't we? And they are painful when they're not on, aren't they?
Yes.
And we know manufacturers think about this because often they leave that little sort of foam or polystyrene on them for when they're delivering them to you. But of course, them springs then catching and banging and chipping the paintwork away. But there's another nice touch, isn't there, when we think about protecting maybe these and changing the bezel, isn't
there? Yeah, there is. So yeah, at first we thought, what's happened here? Is this the lamp picks up a lot of iron filings on our bench.
Yeah.
But then we realised actually when it comes to changing the bezel, so this range is supplied as sort of matte white as standard.
Yeah.
But if you did want to change your bezel.
Yeah, and what colours can we have that bezel in? So we can change it for, Gordon?
You can have it in a black nickel.
Yeah.
You can have it polished chrome or brushed steel as well.
Right, okay.
But the clever bit is they're fixed to the front with magnets.
Oh, right.
So if I just bring this in, you'll get this nice satisfying click.
Yeah.
So you don't have to twist. And sometimes twisting them, obviously, when they're in a ceiling can cause all sorts of problems.
Yeah, damage the ceiling itself.
I'll just do that again.
It's nice, isn't it?
It is.
And again, another reason you can pull those off is when you're decorating, isn't it? So you take those bezels down, you can paint around, you can be a little bit less precise with your cutting in and just drop them on over the top. And you can change them, which is great. Come standard white though, don't they?
Yeah, standard matte white. And while we're on there, Gary, with the thing, you'll notice this one here is slightly recessed at the front, and that's something I like.
Yeah, I know you do like that, yeah.
Yeah, because obviously when you put that sideways, it stops. It's got that good cut off to stop glare and things like that, and I think that helps take light designs to another level.
With that in mind, we've obviously got a different type over here as well. Should we have a look at that as well?
Yeah, so we've got also, yeah, the sort of gimbal version.
Yeah, we have, and they're all a standard depth as well, aren't they? It's 60 mil, isn't it?
Yeah, so again, that's the thing about it. So the F-Type range has been around for a while, but this new version, it's got the 60 millimeter depth with the remote gearbox.
Yeah, and can we cover it with thermal insulation?
Yeah, so not only just the fixture itself, that could be covered with insulation, can also cover the driver module itself. So again, on some of the ones, this has to still stay above the insulation.
Right, okay, that's it, that's good.
So we've got that version, we've got this regressed version, and obviously we've got this fixed version down right here.
Oh, right.
All with those different finishes. So to leave aside some great installer features and think about actually what it's for, it is a light. So what we do want is great lighting performance,
yeah,
and something unique in this product range that we haven't seen from anybody else is dim to warm.
Oh, and we do like a dim to warm, don't
yeah.
we?
Yeah, now we've seen it in lamps before, and this is the first time we've seen it in a phase dimmable, so with conventional rotary dimmers, downlight. So this lamp will change color as you go through that dim curve to match what you would have had in the old days with a incandescent or halogen lamp.
Well, I've actually got some lovely footage where I took the humble apple and dimmed the light over it. Would you like to see that?
Let's have a look at that, Gary.
Here we go then. So
we're eyes on the apple.
Yes. Yeah, keep your eyes focused on the apple as we start to bring it down. But this change in the atmosphere of the room, isn't it, Gordon?
Yeah, so we're going from a sort of between 2,000 and 3,000 degrees Kelvin down to a 2,200, which is the same thing you'd get in the past when you dimmed a halogen lamp down or an incandescent. That very orangey white.
That's right. And look at that. The room now is completely different atmosphere. You're perhaps relaxing in the evening, and they've brought that lighting level down beautifully.
Yeah. Now, some people, you know, when we first showed that in lamps, people said, well, yeah, what difference does that make? That's, you know, is that a desirable effect? Trust me, if you haven't tried it, it does completely change the ambience of a room. It does take that lighting installation to another level. And that combined possibly with this regressed version back into the can,
yeah,
for really me, that is a standout in this product range.
And the wattage in the range is 4 to 6 watts, and that's really important when we start thinking about Part L of the building regs, isn't it?
Yeah, so obviously, yeah, a 4 watt fitting, yes, it actually escapes the requirements of Part L. And if that's something new to you and Part L, we've done a fantastic CPD on that, haven't we, Gary? How did you find out about that?
Well, I would imagine there'll be a link in the description. It's on our website. You go over there, you watch a video on that, and then you can do a few questions. It's CPD accredited. You can then download your certificate and add it to your personal portfolio.
Yeah, and obviously, yeah. If Part L's an alien world, so you take that, you'll know more than you'll ever need to know by the time you've come out of that CPD. So these fittings are very efficient. You know, the headline range is at 100 lumens per watt.
Right, okay.
Which is at the top of the ones we've seen on the market. You lose a little bit of efficiency when you move to the dim to warm.
Right.
But obviously that's because you're gaining that additional features there. Other control options, Gary.
Right, got it.
So we've got selectable white.
Oh. Right, okay. How does that work? Is there a little slider on the back of them?
Exactly. So in most of the fittings that we see on the market, the color, you change the color temperature on the fitting itself.
And you're stuck with it, yeah.
Yeah, and that's buried away in the ceiling. With these ones, you don't do that. Every time you can flick the switch,
yep,
and it will step through the color temperatures.
If you selected that type of downlighter, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, that's really good. So operate the switch, change, yeah, operate the switch, check that.
So 3,000, 4,000 or 6,500 wow, degrees Kelvin. So okay, you know, again, there you might want a warmer white in the morning or in the evening, and possibly something a little bit brighter in the day, or if it's in an office, yeah, you might want to. I know you like to relax at lunchtime, Gary.
Yeah, I do. The range always goes up to IP65, so it can be used in those areas such as bathrooms, etc. And the hot topic in the electrical industry at the moment to do with downlights is I-joists.
Yes.
And have they been tested with
I-joists? Yes, so they've been tested with I-joists. And again, that's something we've looked at on the channel before, and it's something you should check if you're fitting,
yeah,
particularly in new build homes.
Where it's all I-joist or equivalencies in those areas.
So we think this is a pretty powerful package. You know, we didn't think it was possible to innovate any more in downlights, but there's always, yeah, someone taking it just that little stage further to make the electrician's life easier and, importantly, better lighting for the customer, which is what we like. Come with a 5-year warranty.
Wow.
Yeah, 25,000 hour is the stated lamp life on there. So yeah, I think this is a nice little range and worth checking out.
Yeah, so are you thinking about fitting this F-Type range from Luceco? Are you currently fitting it? Is there something you want to give us back for feedback? Is there something we might have missed within the range, which is a hidden gem, and you want to share it with the community? Please leave that comment below, and we will try and get back to as many as we can.